Hi everyone, welcome to a new video. Today we're gonna do something very simple but interesting. Have you ever noticed that sometimes you don't see your desktop icons? They are hidden. So for instance, let me try to also create some folder here. I'll say my folder and I put it on my desktop and say create here. You can see 1, 2, 3, they are here. The trash is here, this is here, this is here. So but at times you find that you can't see those desktop. The reason why icons, the reason why most people they put desktop icons on desktop, or why they want them there, is like for easy access. If you want to click on something, you don't want to go to, maybe you want to get a quick file, a file in some folder, you don't need to go to taskbar or to go to search something small. That's why you can find most people, especially people who are using Windows, you find their taskbar is full of stuff, and also their desktop is full of stuff. So whereby it's not clean all the time. Why? They like things to be closer, you get me? So that's why you find that it's necessary for everybody to know how to put your icons onto your desktop, so if they do disappear and reappear, sometimes you don't know what's going on, what happens, or where you click and stuff. We're going to show you that in Kali Linux, how to do that, so that all the time, if they disappear, you know to bring them, how to bring them back. And also when they appear and you don't want to see them, you know what to do. So this is what we're going to focus on, though you might also see some things which we did not come in here for, but also those going to be like bonus, like when you go to the shop and buy one, they give you two. So here you're gonna get 2 or 3 stuff new. So what you do, go to your taskbar. Also you can see the taskbar, that when you mouse roll over, it comes back here, it comes up and down. So I did also a video on how to put this taskbar here for Kali Linux. Most of you know it's sometimes here or on the right hand side, but especially the default way, it's on its what, left hand side. So you go here and look for what they call, I'm gonna move this this side, it doesn't want to move. Okay, it's fine, but anyway, I can still show you what I want you to see. I want to move this. Yes, I managed to move it. Then we're gonna do what, we're gonna click here. Once we click there, it shows us in another screen. It's fine, but we're gonna search for extension. Look for extension. Now when you search for extension, you see an icon, then you click here. These are the extensions. So the taskbar, what the icons are being found here. You click here, they disappear. You can see, you can't see them. You click back here, they reappear. It's called desktop icons. So you just click the button, they appear or they disappear. So it has also a lot of settings. We want it to be like this, and you can click here and say add icons on the desktop. You can add icons on desktop, or you can click here and say show the personal folder in the desktop, or if you don't want to show that, you can click here and it does what, it goes off. If you click here back, it can show back. If you click, it goes off. You can see that root folder goes away. Show the trash icon. You can take out the trash, or you can put it back, or you can put everything back. Now they ask you, you want a standard icons or you want smaller icons. Depending on your eyes and the space you have, you can do that. So that's one of the bonuses we got. But now you know how to take out the icons and put them back. So also, you're gonna see the dock. You can see the dock as I showed you, to show it and take it back. But also you can see it needs something like it's not stable. Highlight auto hide. You switch off that auto hide, it will never hide again. So that's one of the reason what I told you, we're gonna get a bonus. So before, when you click here, the dock, it been auto hide. But when you click back, it will never auto hide. So you can click here and also click here. There's a couple of things also you can do to maximize your usage of this feature. Enable in full screen if you want to do so. Push to show require pressure to show the dock. Dodge windows, all windows. You can click whatever you want. Only focused application is windows. Only maximized windows. So all of these you can, I believe you can play on these, then they do what, they come on or off. You can see they also show you dock size limit here. Once you click here, you can have that size limit. If you do that, then the limit goes away. So in this tutorial, you've seen that we've showed a lot of things here. If this is where you're gonna go and play with a lot of things here. Isolate workspace, isolate monitors, move applications button to the beginning of the dock. So that simply means animate show application. So you can see it's here, but we can move it like Windows. It's exactly like in Windows now, but now we can move it to this. We can move it here on this place here, but we don't wanna do that. We already put this. So you can see all these, you can see all these things in Kali, that they are possible to look similar to Windows, because most people, they've been using Windows, so they want to do things the way, the old way. So you can do that. Behaviors, you can also use keyboard shortcut to activate apps. So that also can be a settings which you can look into. You can see shortcut for the option above. It says super Q, and then also says syntax shift control alt super. So you can see all of these things, you can do them. But anyway, if you things get out of control and you want to press to restart, to you don't remember what you did, you don't see the behaviors where they came and you don't understand them, you can just simply click on the restore defaults. So it's gonna reset Kali Linux the way those features came, so that you also get fine. So I believe, like you can see the dock I'm using is beautiful, but now I don't like the color, you can see. So since I don't like the color, I can go still back and I change my color. So what I do, I'll go to the dock and see, click there, and I believe it has color somewhere. Auto hide, we do that. It's gonna give us some. I did even made a tutorial about colors, behaviors, appearance. Yeah, it's under appearance. Still, you can select dots, not that. I can select any color, or I can use black here if I want to, because now that one, I don't like it. I realized it was not something good. So also, you can use maybe red, green, or red. So then you select, you can go, I love this color, I think it looks beautiful. So yeah, also that you can play with that. Anything you want to do in Kali, it's already there, it was made for you. So also you can navigate on things like this, and created by Michael. Okay, you can see this, the guy who created this, move the dash auto to overview, coming into a dock. So you can see this guy also put his phone numbers here, his Gmail here, you can email him. He's one of the guys who's behind this to give us things like these extensions, which are pretty beautiful. They give us more power to do things the way we want them to be. Guys, it's time for me to say goodbye, because when I clicked on the website, it took us on that website whereby it shows us how this guy tried to make things easier for us. And his website, Michael, it was also included in Kali, so that you also go and view or see his website and see what he has done for us. If it wasn't for him, maybe you wouldn't have seen this feature in Kali Linux. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video.